Hi, I'm Ryan from Burley, and today I'm going to show you how to install the Dash FM standard rails, Dash FM extended rails, and Dash X FM child bike seats to a bike. Be sure to confirm that your bike is compatible with one of these bike seat models before purchasing it. You can check out our Dash FM fitment video for an easy compatibility checklist. To begin, remove the mounting rails from the mounting block by pressing the front of the block and pulling the rails out of the mounting block. For smooth removal, pull both the mounting rails from the mounting block at the same time. If you have the Dash FM standard rails or FM extended rails, remove the mounting knob by lifting the locking ring up and away from the bike seat and rotating the knob counterclockwise until detached. If you have the Dash X FM, remove the bolt connecting the base plate to the bike seat by rotating it counterclockwise using the included hex wrench. Next, flip the base plate away from the bike seat and remove it from the slots on the underside of the seat. Position the mounting rails so they bend downward, then pass them through the two holes in the front of the bike seat or the front of the reclining system if you have the Dash X FM. For the initial setup, line up the mounting rails with the position number 3 on the underside of the bike seat. These three positions allow you to adjust the horizontal placement of the dash. We'll go over how to do this in a moment. Next, insert the metal base plates into the slots on the underside of the bike seat and flip it down. If you have the Dash FM or FM extended rails, ensure the bolt passes through the slot in the base plate. Then, reattach the mounting knob to the bolt by rotating it clockwise until you can't rotate it any further. During the last few rotations, the locking ring should make an audible clicking noise. When fully tightened, the locking ring should prevent the mounting knob from rotating counterclockwise. If you have the Dash X FM, reattach the bolt by rotating it clockwise to a torque value of 8 Newton meters. If you don't have a torque wrench, please visit a bike shop to ensure the Dash X FM is properly installed. Now that the mounting rails are in place, we're ready to attach the frame mounting system to the bike. Using the provided hex wrench, detach the mounting plate from the mounting block by removing the 4 screws and lock washers. Open the frame protector on the mounting block and wrap it around the seat tube of the bike. Make sure the mounting block is facing forward and the mounting rail holes are facing upward. If there are cables along this part of the bike frame, position them in the central channel between the frame protector and mounting plate, like so. Next, reattach the mounting plate to the mounting block using the 4 screws with lock washers. Tighten them in a crisscross pattern and in stages to a torque value of 8 Newton meters. Be sure to check the security of these fasteners regularly. Now, check that the spacing of the mounting plate and the mounting block is even on all sides. If there are cables along this part of the bike frame, position them in the central channel between the frame protector and mounting block, like so. All right, prep work is complete, and now we can attach the bike seat to the bike. Insert the mounting rails into the two holes on the top of the mounting block until you hear an audible click and the two green safety indicators are visible in the front of the mounting block. Before the seat is ready to ride, we need to check its position and secure the safety strap. Don't skip these steps. They're key to ensuring your little ones stay safe while riding in the dash. Check the position of the bike seat by making sure there's enough space between the base plate on the bottom of the dash and the top of the bike tire so they won't come in contact when the seat is fully loaded. The maximum distance between the base plate and the bike tire when a dash is unloaded is 3.93 inches or 10 centimeters. If the base plate is too far or too close to the bike tire, use the hex wrench to loosen the 4 screws connecting the mounting plate to the mounting block. Move the block up or down the seat tube until the bike seat reaches the correct vertical position. Use the hex wrench to retighten the 4 screws as before. To check the horizontal position of the bike seat, find the center of gravity indicator on the side of the dash. This indicator must be positioned either in front of the bike's rear axle or no more than 3.93 inches, 10 centimeters, behind the bike's rear wheel. If the center of gravity indicator is more than 3.93 inches behind the bike's rear axle, you'll need to adjust the mounting rails on the bottom of the bike seat. To do so, remove the mounting rails from the mounting block by pressing the face of the block and pulling the rails out of the block. If you have the Dash FM standard rails or FM extended rails, remove the mounting knob by pulling the locking ring toward the knob and rotating the knob counterclockwise. For the Dash X FM, use the included hex wrench to remove the bolt by rotating it counterclockwise. Once the mounting knob or bolt is removed, rotate the base plate away from the seat. Then adjust the mounting rails to position 1, 2, or 3 so the bike seat is in the appropriate horizontal position. Secure the base plate as before and reattach the mounting rails to the mounting block. Then, make one final check that the bike seat is in the correct horizontal and vertical positions. Now, we can secure the safety strap. Just pass the safety strap around the seat tube and fasten, securing the buckle. Pull on the free end of the safety strap until it is tightly secured to the bike frame. Make sure the free end of the strap is not able to contact the wheel of the bike. If needed, wrap the safety strap around the seat tube a few times before fastening the buckle. Now that you've attached the dash to the bike, make sure all the bike's components function correctly with the bike seat attached. To buckle your child into the seat, make sure the bike is stable and the dash FM is securely attached before placing them in the seat. Next, snap the shoulder straps and waist straps into the 5-point harness buckle and adjust the straps so they fit securely. This can be done by loosening or tightening the adjustment points on each of the 5 harness straps, like so. For additional adjustment, the shoulder straps can be raised up or down depending on the child's size. To do so, begin by accessing the harness bracket on the back of the dash FM. Rotate the bracket sideways and slide it through the hole and the slot in the seat pad. Then, pass the bracket through the upper harness position hole and rotate it so it's secure against the back of the seat. Repeat on the other shoulder strap, making sure neither strap becomes twisted while adjusting. When adjusting from the upper harness position to the lower harness position, the bracket must be passed back through the slot in the seat pad before passing it through the lower harness position hole. Once the harness is adjusted to fit your child, secure the child's feet using the straps on the footrest. Make sure they're comfortable and that the straps are snug but not too tight. You can adjust the height of each footrest to 4 different positions to keep passengers safe and comfortable. Simply release each footrest from the bike seat by squeezing the tabs on the rear of the footrest together and rotating the footrest up and away from the seat. Then reattach each footrest by inserting the hook in the appropriate notch in the seat and rotate the footrest down and toward the back of the seat until the tabs lock into the notch in the seat. For optimal comfort and safety, the footrest height should be set to allow the child's knees to bend at a 90-degree angle. The Dash XFM includes the option to adjust the recline angle of the bike seat from the standard 0 degrees to either 10 degrees or 20 degrees of recline. To adjust the recline of the seat, detach the safety strap by releasing the buckle. Pull the safety lever away from the recline mechanism, then lift the recline lever up. You can release the safety lever after lifting the recline lever. While lifting up on the recline lever, lift the front of the bike seat upward to increase the recline angle. Once the seat is at the desired 0, 10, or 20 degree recline, release the recline lever and safety lever so it's flush with the side of the recline mechanism. Don't forget to reattach the safety strap. Now, you're ready to explore with your favorite co-pilot. At the end of the ride, press the yellow release button on the 5-point harness to remove the child. To remove the dash from the bike, detach the safety strap by releasing the buckle. Remove the seat from the mounting block by pressing the front of the block and pulling the rails out of the block. Pro tip, it's easiest to remove the rails from the mounting block if you grab the front of the bike seat where the rails pass through the bike seat. To remove the frame mounting assembly from your bike, begin by removing the mounting plate from the mounting block. Use the provided hex wrench to remove the 4 screws. Be careful not to lose the lock washers. Then remove the mounting block from the frame. The steps to remove the mounting rails from the bike differ slightly depending on if you have the Dash FM standard rails, FM extended rails, or Dash XFM. For the Dash FM standard rails and FM extended rails, remove the mounting knob by pulling the locking ring toward the knob and rotating the knob counterclockwise. For the Dash XFM, use the included hex wrench to remove the bolt by rotating it counterclockwise. Once you've removed the mounting knob or bolt, rotate the base plate away from the seat. Then slide the mounting rails through the 2 holes. Check out the Dash product manuals for full safety guidelines, maintenance info, and a pre-ride safety checklist. For more information on the Dash FM models and other Burley products, visit burley.com/videos.